Good evening and welcome back to English Journey. My name is Svetozar, that's another class of English. Today is Monday, that's quite late. I hope to see some students because today we're gonna be listening to an interesting podcast, the title of which is cheese, or something usually people usually say when taking a photo. Cheese, make a cheese, so to let people smile. So that is the title. I won't let the cat out of the bag beforehand. The topic is cheese. We will discuss for sure cheese and your preferences in cheese. And here is the first student who has come up and left. Okay, and there is the second student. And hello to you. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you again.
How was the day?
The day was very good.
Oh, okay. So did you go out, Anne?
What's mean good go out?
I mean, did you leave your home for a while to have some fresh air?
Yes, I left my home. No, I don't go out. Yes,
didn't go. I haven't gone out. If you maybe you can do that. So I haven't gone out today. Sorry.
Yes.
Well, why not? You need to, you know, to have a gulp of fresh air.
Because today it's rainy. Strong rainy.
Really? Is it? Is it raining? Okay, where can you please remind me where you live?
I live in Russia, in Makhachkala, in Dagestan.
Oh, I see. Okay, so it is raining. Bad luck to go out. Good. Well, anyway, so what have you been doing all the day? Have you been studying?
Today I tried to analyze whole information which I got in your two lessons.
I see. Okay, very good. Very good students you are. So thank you for that. Mikhail, good evening to you. How are you feeling? Good as usual?
As usual.
No changes?
No. It's hard to change. Hard to change my feeling. Yeah, not feeling. How to say it right?
Sorry?
How to say it right? It's hard to change my not feelings. So something like.
I don't know what you want to say. So hard to change my state. I don't know. Well. Attitude to life. I don't know. It depends.
I mean, in Russian, it's "dela." You know, it's like in Russian "dela." Maybe. Тяжело сделать плохо. Вот как это правильно сказать? Черт возьми.
Difficult to do bad. Well, what you want to say? To do bad? To do something bad? I mean, it's difficult to change things for worse. Maybe if it's what you want to say. It's difficult to change things for worse. Well, I don't want you to change things for worse. Let me type for you. So, difficult to change things for worse. So, that's it. If it's what you want to say. Well, I don't want you to change things for worse. Just you always say that everything is fine, it is good. That's something really good in what you say. If things are good with you, that's fantastic. Just I want you to share with us a little bit, you know, about something that happens in your life from one day to another one, because every day brings us something new. Well, yesterday it was the 5th of October, today is the 6th of October, so it's already something different. It's a unique day. The 6th of October 2014 will never return to your life, so you should try to live it as if it were your last day. You know, once I read a book and I liked it immensely, and there was an idea about that, so that we should try to look for some little moments of joy or maybe happiness in every day, because we never know what will happen tomorrow. And by the way, today is one of my sister's birthday. She lives in Ila Cerkva, in my native town. So that's it. Well, a piece of news from my
mom. If she has a birthday, maybe we can
congratulate.
Not translate. How to say it? We can
Send our best regards.
Send our regards. Yes.
Thank you. Well, I will give her a call, and after the class, and I'll tell her that my students and well, yeah, that's it. My students. Her best regards. Good things. Thanks. Well, today I went out to send her my present because unfortunately I couldn't be there in my native town because I have to work. So she'll get her present tomorrow and I guess she'll be pleased. So I tried to do my best to please her. So that's it. It's just a piece of news from my part. Good. So today is Monday. And it's quite late. However, you are here, and I'm grateful for that. Hope other students will join. I can see there are three viewers, like three people watching us. But why don't they join us here online? So, guys, if you wish, you can do that. Don't be shy, okay? We won't bite you. We will just have a great time speaking, discussing, and listening. So today we're gonna be listening to a podcast. And the title of this is cheese. Not really cheese, but the keyword is cheese. The expression is to be cheesed off, but the keyword is cheese. So before we listen to the before we jump into listening part, I'd like to ask you some questions about cheese. And the first question is quite predictable. So do you like cheese, Anne?
Yes, I like cheese.
I love it. What about you, Mikhail? Do you like cheese?
Yes, I like to eat cheese.
You like to eat cheese. Okay.
And do you like cheese?
I love it. I have just said it. I love it. I really like it a lot. I haven't tasted many types of cheese, but I'd like to do that. I just know that there are a lot of different cheeses, if you can say so, or sorts of cheese, types of cheese. Well, the cheese I tasted, I like them a lot, so hope to taste some other. Okay, before we listen, I've got a question here for you based on cheese. So, well, the first question is already asked. How often do you buy cheese? So I will ask you the question. Then I will give you variants. You will choose one of the four, and after that we'll discuss it a little bit. So the first question, actually the second one, is how often do you buy cheese? And how often do you buy cheese? Never, once a month, once a week, more than once a week.
More than once a week.
More than once a week. Oh, yeah. Lucky you are. So you have such an opportunity to buy cheese more than twice a week. Okay, and where do you usually buy cheese? In a supermarket or in special, I don't know, shops, dairy shops?
My mother bought it. I don't know where she did it.
My mother does. Yeah, my mother buys cheese. I don't know where she does. Because you use the past. You mean in general, usually, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So my mother my mother buys it.
Buys it, and I don't know where she does it.
I see. So it's a little secret of hers, I guess. Okay. Good. So, and how do you know that your mother buys cheese twice a week?
My mother buys cheese less than
once a week.
Yes, but I eat it long.
Okay. It takes you long to eat the cheese. Okay.
Yes.
So, are you the only person in the family who eats cheese? Does your mom buy cheese only for you?
But I like more than another person in my family.
Everyone in the family does like cheese. Just it's you are the one who loves it. We can say, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I see. Okay, thank you for sharing. Well, another question. How often do you buy fresh dairy products? Yogurt, cream, butter, dairy desserts? Mikhail?
Maybe try to.
Okay, there is another new student. I'm afraid to mispronounce your name. By, oh, I don't know, Bauerjan.
Bauerjan.
Will you correct me, please?
Bauerjan.
Bauerjan.
No.
Bauerjan. Is that correct?
Right.
Bauerjan, right?
Right, right.
Okay, good. So, Bauerjan, where did he come from?
I'm from Kazakhstan.
Okay, nice to meet you. Is it the first time you're here?
Yes, right.
Okay, you are switching off your microphone all the time. Could you just switch it?
No, no, Svetozar, it depends on computer. It's everything
really? All right. Mm-hmm. Because I can't, well, because I can see that the microphone is muted and
mm-hmm.
I can't. Mm, okay, good. So, Bayrojan, will you tell us a few words about yourself? What do you do in life, you know, your hobbies, dislikes, interests, work, motivation in studying English, and things like that?
Okay, I still cannot understand. Someone hear me or no?
Yes, we can hear you, absolutely.
Okay, that's perfect. So, I live in Dubai now. I'm right now in Dubai and I work here. I don't know what.
I can hear, but not very clearly. So, where do you work? What do you do in your life? Bauerjan?
I work as a system management administrator.
Okay, good. What are your interests? What do you like? What are your hobbies?
I like a lot of things. I like to go to swim in the sea. I like girls.
Sorry? What do you like?
I like girls. Girls.
Girls, okay. Oh. I see. What else?
What else?
Do you like learning English?
Yes, I like. That's why I'm here.
Okay, and what is your motivation? Why do you learn English? Just for fun, for pleasure, for traveling, when you need it for work?
It's really necessary here because Dubai it's probably used language. And I need to communicate to people. I really need English.
Mm-hmm. So it's a kind of a necessity for you. Well, I can say that I can hear you, but not very properly. Sometimes
okay.
I lose some of the words you're pronouncing.
Cesar, maybe we can. I see the microphone of M. Yes, maybe we try to turn it off, and after that, N. Do you hear me? Well, thank you.
Well, okay, but I don't think it will help.
No.
But maybe. Well, anyway, you are welcome to the class, by John. So hope that to be useful for you. And so let's greet a new student, Ina. Hello to you. Ina, hello?
Oh, okay, hello.
Okay, so where do you come from?
I'm from Ukraine, from Zolotonosha. It's a Caucasian region.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Well, great. And will you tell us a few words about yourself? Do you study? Do you work? Do you have any hobbies, interests, particular?
No.
Will you tell us a little bit about yourself, about your work, hobbies, interests, and this kind of stuff?
I can listen to you.
You cannot hear me?
Awfully.
Awfully? Well, I don't know why. Okay, so what shall we do? Michael, your microphone is muted now. So I
maybe Ina try to turn it off and turn it on, and we can see if we have a noise on this computer. Yes.
I cannot hear you properly. I think there's something wrong, really. So okay. Well, Mihail, we have switched off Ina's microphone. Why?
It's like a test. I just try to see where the noise.
Okay. So, Ina, can you hear me? Mikhail, so Ina, now your microphone is muted. Could you please switch it on? Because I cannot hear you now. Ina? Hello? Ina, can you hear me? You cannot hear me.
Cesar, maybe if you have some problem with the microphone, try to speak to all.
Okay, but still, Ina should try. Ina, well, unfortunately, I
can hear your voice. So.
Cannot hear me. You can hear me. So, anyway, guys, you are welcome to the class. I don't know if you have some problems with the microphone, please try to maybe lock off then lock on. Sometimes it helps. But when you don't speak, please switch off your microphones because there is some noise coming from your rooms and that prevents me from hearing others. Okay. Well, so let's come back to the topic of our class. So today we are going to be listening to the podcast. And so we were discussing some questions. So I was asking questions about cheese because that is the topic of our class. Of our podcast tonight. So the last question I asked was, how often do you buy cheese? And that was Anne who answered the question. And as far as I remember, Anne's mom usually buys cheese approximately twice a week. And Anne is the person who is a cheese lover in the family. And the next question is, how often do you buy fresh dairy products like yogurt, cream, butter, and dairy desserts? So, question for your name, really, Bayujan. Difficult to pronounce. So, Bayujan, how often? There was not how often. Sorry. How often do you buy fresh dairy products? Never, once a month, once a week, or more than once a week. Something like yogurt, cream, butter, and dairy desserts. So, Bayerjan?
So, we didn't. We don't buy any. But we just went to a restaurant. And,
the last variant, you mean? So, more than once a week?
No. We never buy.
Never buy dairy products. Why not? Don't you like them?
No, it's not reason. Because we don't cook at home. We go to the restaurant and have a meal there.
You eat only in restaurant time, right? Yes.
We eat only in restaurant.
Okay, you eat only in restaurant. You mean cheese, but what about yogurt, some butter, or cream, or dairy desserts? You never buy it then, do you?
Sometimes, maybe, just on to the dinner, you buy some fresh milk, or something like yogurt, yes.
Mm-hmm. So you sometimes buy? But not very often.
That is really.
Really, okay, I see. Good. And so, if you buy, what kind of dairy products do you buy?
As I said, there are yogurt.
Mm-hmm. Milk, yogurt. What else? Okay, so milk and yogurt. And how often do you buy it? Once a week?
It depends on my pleasure.
On your... What does it depend on?
It depends on my desire.
On your desire, I see. Good. Well, thank you. Well, another question. What is your budget for cheese per purchase? How much money do you spend on cheese, Mikhail? Are you participating?
How much money?
Yeah, how much money do you spend?
When I buy cheese, I just maybe I see on the weight of this product, but not maybe it's.
Well, do you buy much cheese per purchase? You know, like if you purchase means that you go to the supermarket or whatever, wherever, and you buy some cheese. So, is it a big amount of cheese or just a little?
I think it's a middle amount of cheese because we have not a very good cheap variants of cheese. It's not very tasty. I try to buy in the middle level.
I see. Price. Okay. Good. Well, another question. What is your daily... there is about budget, about for lunch. No, that's not an interesting question. This one. So, what cheese do you generally buy? Variants. French cheese, like Camembert, Roquefort, Conti. English cheese, like Cheddar and Stilton. Italian cheese, like Gorgonzola, Mozzarella, and others. Or some other cheese. And question for you. Question for your mom.
No one. We often...
None.
We often buy Brinza.
Okay. I see. So you are a Brinza lover. Good. What about you, Bayerjan? What cheese do you buy? Well, you never buy cheese. Is that you eat it only in restaurants? Bayerjan? Can you hear me?
I have no idea about type of cheese. It doesn't matter for me.
Doesn't matter. So yeah. It can be either French or Italian or English or, I don't know, different nationalities. Like English, French, and Italian cheeses are most well-known all over the world. So, but it doesn't matter for you what kind of cheese. Yeah?
I heard about Holland cheese.
By the way.
That's it.
You've never tasted any French cheese, have you?
No. I didn't try.
Why not?
How to say it? With the how to say it in English? With the French cheese with
moldy cheese. Moldy cheese. Write it for you just a second. So molded cheese. Yeah, they don't smell very good sometimes and. They say that one should get used to it. Moldy cheese. Okay, just a second. Moldy cheese. So usually, but I guess not only French cheese is moldy, but it is considered to be a very tasty one.
Mm-hmm.
So Barjan has never tasted French cheese. Well,
all time I think in Dubai there is no problem with the cheese and with any kind of food. I think it's very simple.
No, it's not simple. It's not just ordinary mold. It's special, and there are a lot of technologies to. Produce moldy cheese of good quality. That is why it is that expensive, not that It's not just that you leave a cheese at the balcony, I don't know, under the sun and voila, you've got moldy cheese. It will be a little bit different, okay?
Okay.
So, Ina, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay, that's lovely. So we are discussing cheese, as you could, well, you could just notice that. So what about you, Inna? What kind of cheese do you prefer? French one, Italian, English, or others?
I don't like cheese, but my mom very likes cheese. She eats
a lot of it.
In all kind of food.
I see. Okay. Why don't you like cheese?
I don't know.
Do you like any other dairy products, like milk, yogurts, or cream?
Yeah, I like milk. When I was a child, I loved milk.
And what about now? Do you still like it?
Now it's so-so.
So-so, okay, you're not that fan. Okay, good. So, well, cheese, my questions, well, about cheese. Okay, well, here is another question. So, what type of cheese do you generally buy, or do you generally like eating? Hard cheese, soft cheese, or cheese with parsley? If you know what parsley is. So soft cheese, there is la brie camembert, so it's something like Anne mentioned, brinza, you said, yeah?
Yes.
So it's very, very close to it. So, and as far as I understood, you prefer soft cheese, yeah?
No, it can be soft or more hot. It depends on the manner of cooking this cheese.
Okay, I see. And do you like cheese with parsley? You know what parsley is?
I don't know what it means.
Parsley. Who knows what parsley means? No dictionary consultant, please. Barjan, do you know what parsley is?
I have no idea. Either.
Okay, so, yeah? Ina? Who knows? Anne?
I know, yes.
Okay.
I think it is plants, no plants, herbal. Yes.
That's right, but you said you didn't know.
I like parsley, yes.
Okay. No, the point is that I asked you if you knew the word and you said you didn't. Okay, forget it. No matter. Okay, just I try not to consult dictionaries. I want you to guess the meaning of the words. If you don't know, I will give you the definition in English. And
Give me the definition, please, because I don't hear it.
I will give you the definition taken from Oxford Dictionary. It's just not translation, but a definition. So, and I know if it will help you, but let's try. So it's a kind of a plant with white flowers, but actually we don't usually eat them. So with aromatic leaves, which are either crinkly, like, you know, crispy, or flat, and are used as a culinary herb and for garnishing foods. So it's a kind of a plant with green leaves. We usually add into some salads or into other dishes just to make it make it tastier, and just sometimes to garnish it. To garnish means to decorate somehow your dish. So there is parsley.
Mm-hmm.
Have you understood the meaning?
Yes, I just push on this word and I have a translation. I'm sorry.
Okay. What for asking for a definition then?
No. When you say it, I didn't just to click on this word. And
okay, I see. So that's it. So hard cheese, soft cheese, and cheese with parsley. Mihail, what about you? What kind of cheese do you prefer?
I prefer hard cheese.
Hard cheese. Okay, so do I. Well, some more questions. What do you normally eat or drink with your cheese? Wine, bread, crackers, fruit, vegetables, jam, honey, or something else? So what if you eat cheese, when you eat cheese, what do you usually like eating with it? So as far as have I just mentioned, wine, bread, crackers, fruit, vegetables, or something else. Bayurjan.
Ah.
Yeah, very interesting way you react. Yeah. Okay. So, what do you usually eat or drink with cheese when you eat it? Wine, you know, or maybe some bread, vegetable, fruit.
I think it's. I like cheese with bread and put it in the microwave.
Okay.
And
get a cheeseburger or something like that.
And burn.
And?
I don't know how to say it, but in the microwave it burn, right?
So you bake it somehow. So you put a slice of cheese on a slice of bread. You put it in a microwave and you prepare it to bake it somehow. Yeah.
Bake it.
Okay. Sounds tasty. Good. Okay.
Like pizza. Like on the pizza.
Yeah, kind of a pizza. Good. And so do you usually drink anything with that cheeseburger of yours?
Only milk.
Whoa, it's impossible to drink milk with cheese. I don't know, it's not very good idea.
No, it should be very delicious.
I'm sorry?
It should be very delicious because cheese is useful milk, and milk also useful in milk.
Okay, so do you really drink milk with that sandwich of yours?
Why no?
I don't know. Well, sounds. Sounds unusual, I would say. Okay, so you like drinking milk with that cheeseburger of yours. I guess that Mikhail knows you well, doesn't he? It was just a supposition. Okay, Mikhail, what about you? What do you usually drink or eat with your cheese?
I like cheeseburger like Borjan, but I don't drink milk with them. I like to eat it with how to say salt, not salt, cucumber.
Salt
cucumbers. Yes.
Okay.
Pickled cucumbers.
I see you. By the way, Valery, how was your day? Nice to see you again.
Yeah, nice to see you too. Nice to see you too. Yeah.
Okay.
It was just a regular Monday. Quite a hard day.
And what about weekends? Staying home?
We went for a walk to the Patriarch Puns. Just stayed at home, and fortunately, we didn't go to the countryside to my parents' in law.
Why not?
Well, I don't feel like working in the garden, you know.
It's
not my thing to do.
Okay, it's not your cup of tea.
Yeah.
I see. Well, did you find any pretext not to go there?
Well,
we just said I don't want. That's enough.
My wife took care of it, and she made the pretext.
I see. Okay. Well, anyway, welcome back. So we are discussing cheese. Different kinds of cheese. My last question was about what do you usually like eating with your cheese or drink? What about you, Valery? Do you like cheese in general?
I am indifferent to cheese.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I can eat it if I'm offered, but I would never. Well, I often buy cheese just because my wife is a cheese lover.
Mm-hmm.
But if I lived alone, I would never buy cheese myself.
Like, don't you?
Pardon?
You prefer meat, I believe, don't you?
Yes, I'm a meat lover. Yeah, okay. For sure.
I see. Well, and if you are offered some cheese, what would you eat it with? I mean, maybe some bread, some vegetables, maybe some fruit, or a glass of wine, or I don't know. Well, one of the students here, whose name is Barjan, so a new student, so he likes eating cheese with a glass of milk. What about you?
I would eat it with on a slice of bread. covered with butter, and I will put...
Covered with butter? Or
yes.
So first cheese and then butter?
Slice of bread covered with butter.
Okay, I see.
Then I put a piece of cheese on it. And eat it with a cup of tea. Tea with milk.
Still milk. So milk goes into cup.
Because I never drink tea without milk.
Okay, so I can see there are a lot of milk lovers here. Good, thank you for sharing. And so what about you, Ina? So your mother likes cheese. You don't like it that much. Do you ever eat cheese?
I eat cheese today.
What do you eat with?
What?
What do you eat it with? I mean, bread, fruit, vegetables?
Bread, and I like to drink tea. That is very.
I'm afraid I haven't understood everything, Brett. There is something I caught. And what about drinks? Do you ever drink anything together with your cheese?
Yeah, I drink tea.
Green tea?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Is there anybody who likes drinking wine with cheese or, I don't know, or maybe a cup of coffee? And what about you?
Well, I can eat cheese with everything except drinks. I don't like cheese with drinks.
You don't like it with some drinks. Okay, why not?
Because I don't like mix a different product.
Okay, so if you're eating cheese, that is only cheese. If it's tea, well, that will be separately. Don't you ever, I don't know, eat any cookies or any cakes or any pie with any drinks like tea or coffee or anything like that?
Yes, sometimes.
You sometimes do, but if it's about cheese, no other products to go with.
Yes.
Okay, good. So thanks, guys, for sharing about your likes and dislikes about cheese. I have discovered a lot of interesting things like milk, drinking milk together with cheese, and other things. Now, what we're gonna do? We're gonna be listening to a podcast, and it will be somehow about cheese. So you will discover it when listening. So the first thing we're going to do, we will listen to it. The task is to try to understand as much as possible. After that, we will discuss it for sure. And then we will listen to it for the second time. And you'll have a possibility to read a transcription. So let's get started. Please get your microphones muted, okay? And we will start. So, cheers.
The English We Speak from the BBC.
Hi, Finn. Oh, you don't look that happy today. Here, have a bit of cheese.
No thanks, Lee.
It's tasty. Italian cheese, my favourite.
Well, thank you, Lee, but, you know, I'm sorry. I'm just in a terrible mood today. Do you know I have to spend the whole weekend writing a report?
Oh, really?
Yeah, the boss said my first draft wasn't good enough and asked me to do the whole thing again by Monday.
Oh, not much fun. Sorry, Finn.
Hmm.
Are you sure you don't want some cheese?
No cheese for me, thanks. You know, I'm really cheesed off.
Cheesed off?
Okay, before we continue, listening to the podcast... So there is the expression. What is the expression? Have you heard it? Ina.
What?
Have you heard the expression, the key expression of this podcast? Related to cheese.
Expression? The woman likes cheese.
No. I mean, what is the key word combination, you know, the idiomatic expression? Have you caught it from this passage? You haven't?
I think it's question to Valerie.
the very last words.
The very last words. That's right.
Of this passage.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm sure Valeria has thoughts. Just want first to hear other opinions, and if nobody has thoughts, Valeria will help us. Anne, have you heard?
About?
So have you heard the idiomatic expression?
Yes.
Expression yes, of this book. Okay, so what is that?
The man who has reports, who has wrote reports for week with very bad, and he don't want to eat cheese because he was sad and he's...
Okay, so what was the expression? What is the idiomatic expression? As Valeri has just said, it is used at in the last sentence. He said that he just explained the way he felt, and he used that expression. And his friend, that woman, she repeated it. Did you catch it? Okay, let me make you listen once again to the last part.
Oh, not much fun. Sorry, Finn. Are you sure you don't want some cheese?
No cheese for me, thanks. You know, I'm really cheesed off.
Cheesed off?
That's it.
Cheesed off.
Mm-hmm. Be cheesed off. So to be cheesed off means, but Eddie, will it give us a kind of a definition of this idiomatic expression?
That's the first time I hear this expression, but so I can only guess. It can mean that that the person doesn't feel like eating some cheese, or maybe he always dislikes eating cheese.
Perhaps. Okay. Thank you for your supposition. Barjan, will you please give me your idea? What do you mean? What do you think the expression to be cheesed off? What can it mean? Barjan, your microphone is muted, I guess. Will you please unmute yourself?
I have same opinion as Vladimir.
Valeri, you mean?
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. So you think that to be cheese off means not to be a cheese lover, not to wish, not to have a desire to eat any cheese? Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Okay, I see your point. Well, Ina, what is your idea about the expression?
I think that this man think about his problem, and he in not a good mood.
So he is not in a mood to eat some cheese.
Yes, he is not a mood a good mood to eat. Anything. Oh,
anything. Okay. Not only cheese, just anything. Okay, thank you. And do you agree with Valeri and Barjan or Ina?
I agree with Valeri.
Okay, so you agree with Valeri. And Mikhail, what about you? What's your idea? What's your opinion on the matter?
About cheese off, yes.
To be cheesed off or to feel cheesed off?
Maybe this means the person eats cheese all the time and on this moment, it's too much.
Okay, so the person has eaten too much of cheese and can't.
He's fed up with cheese.
Fed up with cheese. So just a lot of cheese, like up to the throat. Okay, so he's fed up with it. Okay, now let's listen to the rest of the podcast and find out if you were right or if you were close to the truth. So, please get your microphones muted, and let's continue. Okay, there is some car where I know what's passing by, so let's continue.
Is that a...
I'm really cheesed off.
Cheesed off? Is that a medical problem? You can't eat cheese?
No. In English, to be cheesed off means to be really annoyed. I'm so cheesed off. You can also say to cheese someone off. So, writing reports really cheeses me off.
So, now I know why you are cheesed off.
That's right.
Okay, so what is the idea, Valeri?
So that person is very annoyed. And so he...
to be very annoyed. Perhaps someone doesn't know the meaning of this expression. To be very annoyed.
So for example, in that situation, that person has to write a report, and he hates doing that. So he's in a very bad mood, so he feels angry, annoyed, frustrated maybe.
Very good, absolutely. Yeah.
So,
to be cheesed off actually means everything you have just mentioned. Thanks a lot. So have you guys understood the meaning of the expression? Anne?
Yes, I understand.
Okay, good. Ina, what about you? Is that clear? Anne? Ina. Ina? Your microphone is muted. Please unmute yourself. Well, don't forget to mute yourself, but don't forget either to unmute yourself.
I'm here.
So have you understood the meaning of the expression? Not really.
Yes.
Well, I would... I don't really think that you have understood, or maybe not 100%.
So-so. Just...
Well, actually, something that you were very close to it. You said the person was in a bad mood. So he is in bad mood because he's annoyed, he's tired, if you wish, after working over the project, over the reports, and he doesn't feel like doing that. So he doesn't feel like eating anything. He doesn't feel like doing anything because he has some heavy thoughts on his mind. That's it. Okay. So, to be cheesed off. Now, let's continue. There will be some examples. So, please try to catch the examples and try to remember them because I would like you to quote them after listening to the passage, the part of the podcast. So, now please get yourself muted back and let's move on.
You are cheesed off.
That's right. Cheesed off is today's expression in authentic, real English. Let's hear some examples of how it's used.
Working with Caroline is not easy. She gets really cheesed off when people don't agree with her.
Okay, so let's do it example by example. So the first example is Anne.
First example about people who...
About a person, Caroline.
Caroline, I forget.
Okay, try to keep it in mind. I know it's not that easy, but it's what I want you to do. So once again, maybe someone remembers? Huh?
So...
I remember.
Okay, good. You're welcome.
She don't like when somebody don't agree with her.
Doesn't like, yeah. She doesn't like when someone... doesn't agree with her, and how does she feel? She feels cheesed off. Okay, well, let's continue.
In authentic, real English. Okay, let's hear some examples of how it's used.
Working with Caroline is not easy. She gets really cheesed off when people don't agree with her.
Just the first part is a little bit different, but the idea is that it's not easy, to work with. Mm-hmm. Good, because she gets cheesed off when somebody disagrees with her.
Let's hear some examples of how it's used.
Okay, once again.
Working with Caroline is not easy. She gets really cheesed off when people don't agree with her.
My sister cheeses me off. She borrows all my clothes and never returns them.
Okay, example for Valerie, please.
That woman is irritated with her sister, who borrows her clothes and never gives it back.
Exactly. Okay, but will you please try to use the expression with the cheese?
Yeah. So that woman is cheesed off with her sister because she... her sister takes away all her clothes and never returns it.
That's right. Well, just here in this very example, the expression was used in a little bit different way. So to be cheesed off, but you can also say...
To get, yeah?
To cheese someone off.
Ah, okay, yeah.
Here, as she said, my sister
Yeah, that sister cheeses her off.
Exactly, that's right.
Taking her sister's clothes.
Yeah, borrowing all the time her clothes.
Yeah, borrowing, yeah.
Never returning them back. Mm-hmm. Never returning them, just good.
She gets really cheesed off when people don't agree with her.
My sister cheeses me off. She borrows all my clothes and never returns them. Mm-hmm. No need to be cheesed off, Finn. I can help you with your report.
Oh, really? Well, you're such a sweetie, Lee. Thanks.
But you have to do what I say.
Okay, what do I have to do?
First thing, have some of this cheese.
Okay. This is quite delicious. Can I have some more, Lee?
You see, I knew you would feel better after eating something. Mm. You weren't just angry. You were hungry. Feeling a bit better now?
Oh, yes. Oh, lovely. Thank you. Now, let's get this done.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, so what's happened? Barjan, what did that woman offer her friend, Finn and Lee, I guess, Lee? So what did Lee offer Finn?
She offered the to your friend.
She offered?
Yes.
Well, first she offered, she said she would help him, yeah? She said that she would help him with his report, but just he had to do something for her. Mm-hmm. It was a condition. So what did he have to do to get her help?
Yeah, of course, he has to eat the cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Am I right?
Will you please repeat, because I'm afraid I haven't got you.
At first, he had to eat a bit of cheese.
Well, has anyone got to guess? I cannot get what you are saying, Verjan. What about you guys? Have you heard? Because I don't know, maybe.
I haven't heard him.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, will you repeat once again, Barjan? Try to pronounce clearly, okay? Because your connection isn't that very good.
She offered to eat a piece of cheese.
That's right, exactly. So that's what she wanted him to do. So she says, I will help.
He has eaten this piece of cheese.
Yeah.
And became to feel better, much better.
Exactly. Well, not just got better or felt better. So, exactly. Now I finally have heard you. Very good. So she said to him, I will help you, but you'll have to do something for me. So, and then he replied, what shall I do? And she gave him a piece of, it's like maybe several slices of cheese. And he did enjoy it, and he even asked for more, because it was quite delicious. And so what was Lee's conclusion, that girl's conclusion? What did she say at the end, Ina? You remember what she said?
What he said?
No, what she said. So after he tasted the cheese and liked it and asked for...
That this kind of cheese, her favorite? I don't know.
What she said at the beginning, that was her favorite Italian cheese, but what did Lee, the woman, say at the end when her friend Finn...
At the end, she said that she will help him.
Is that... I'm listening to you and trying to understand, but I'm afraid I'm not. Who remembers what she said? What is little comment about being angry?
I can remember.
Okay, Anne, will you please tell us?
He was no angry, he was hungry.
Yes, thank you very much. So that's what I wanted to hear. So she said that you were not angry, you were hungry.
Yes.
I think that's right. Okay, so do you agree that when a person is hungry, the person is usually angry. Oh, vice versa. When the person is angry, the person is hungry. Valeri, are you usually angry when you are hungry? Valeri?
Yes, I am.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And is it dangerous to be by your side when you are hungry?
No, I'm a harmless person, you know.
Really?
So yeah, I try to shun away from my wife when she's hungry, but I try not to be on her way to the kitchen, you know.
I see.
Yes, when she's cooking, when she's hungry, and when she's cooking, I'd rather stay in the next room.
I see. So she is hungry and she is cooking. That's double problem, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's her duty.
Okay, good. And Mikhail, what about you? Are you usually angry when you are hungry?
No. I think I'm not angry.
Yeah. Okay. So it's not about you. So when the person is hungry, the person is really hungry. And what about you, Bayerjan?
This is exactly about me.
Really? So you are usually angry when you are hungry.
Yes, I am.
And so what do you usually eat? Do you treat people not in a very polite way? What happens when you are angry?
What happens?
Mm-hmm. What happens? What usually happens when you are angry?
What do you mean? I'm stressed.
You are stressed. Okay, you feel cheesed off.
Yes, I'm pissed off.
Okay, so when I'm you can say that when I'm hungry or when I'm angry, I'm cheesed off. Yeah, yes. Try to use these expressions. That's the aim of our working with them. So we can say that I'm really cheesed off when I'm angry or when I'm hungry, because there is something equal for hungry and angry. I may have mispronounced hungry and angry. That's it. Okay, guys, so now I will give you the link. You will have a possibility to read to the transcription once again, and we will listen to it for the second time. And then I'll let you go just for a second. So here it goes, the link, and Valeri, I will send you now the link as well. Mikhail taught me, but let me try. This one, I guess.
You see the handout in the.
Yeah. Just a second. So, does it work?
Yes.
Yeah, I see the link.
Good, very good. So, will you try to get it downloaded?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. What about you guys, Inna and Berjan? Can you see the link?
Yeah.
What is written, Berjan? I haven't got your question.
This is off.
Sorry?
This is off.
This?
This is off.
Cheesed off to be cheesed off.
Yeah.
You will see in the podcast. But can you see the link, Bayerjan?
Yes, I can.
So please click on the link, and there will have a possibility to get a file downloaded.
Yes. Thank you.
But you have to get it downloaded because it's not very legible on this site. So let me show you. Over there. Can you see my screen now?
Yeah.
Okay, so here there is a button that will let you get the file downloaded on your computer. Okay?
Thank you.
So click on it, and then you will have a file on your computer, and you will be able to read it without any problems. And so, Inna, same for you, because you are the first time here. Can you see what you should do?
Yeah.
Good.
I did it.
Great. Okay. So, does everyone have the file now? Yeah? Good. So, now please mute your microphones and let's listen once again. You'll just have the possibility to read listening for the second time.
The English We Speak from the BBC.
Hi, Finn. Oh, you don't look that happy today. Here, have a bit of cheese.
No thanks, Lee.
It's tasty. Italian cheese, my favourite.
Well, thank you, Lee, but, you know, I'm sorry. I'm just in a terrible mood today. Do you know I have to spend the whole weekend writing a report?
Oh, really?
Yeah, the boss said my first draft wasn't good enough and asked me to do the whole thing again by Monday.
Oh, not much fun. Sorry, Finn.
Mm.
Are you sure you don't want some cheese?
No cheese for me, thanks. You know, I'm really cheesed off.
Cheesed off? Is that a medical problem? You can't eat cheese?
No. In English, to be cheesed off means to be really annoyed. I'm so cheesed off. You can also say to cheese someone off. So, writing reports really cheeses me off.
So, now I know why you are cheesed off.
That's right. Cheesed off is today's expression in authentic real English. Let's hear some examples of how it's used.
Working with Caroline is not easy. She gets really cheesed off when people don't agree with her.
My sister cheeses me off. She borrows all my clothes and never returns them. No need to be cheesed off, Finn. I can help you with your report.
Oh, really? Oh, you're such a sweetie, Lee. Thanks.
But you have to do what I say.
Okay, what do I have to do?
First thing, have some of this cheese.
Okay, this is quite delicious. Can I have some more, Lee?
You see, I knew you would feel better after eating something. Mm. You weren't just angry, you were hungry. Feeling a bit better now?
Oh, yes. Oh, lovely. Thank you. Now, let's get this done.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, so that'll do. I hope that it helped you to understand the podcast better. Try not to forget the expression, try to use it. Try not to get cheesed off when someone annoys you or when you have some problems to deal with. So have a nice evening, sleep tight, and hope to see you next time at my class. So thanks for joining this class. Was glad to meet new students. Was glad to see someone I know already. Spend a good night and see you later, guys. Bye for now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thank you very much.
Welcome. Bye.